first, take a piece of wood, preferably pine. Then carve a face and some hair. Carve the body, working down to the legs and feet. Then, of course, add some arms, paint the face and the hair, then perhaps add a beautiful hat and some knickerbockers and a petticoat and a beautiful lace dress with a little pinafore and perhaps, just to complete the outfit, a handbag. And you have what can pass very easily as a Victorian doll, but it isn't. They were all made, all the ones here, by Marlene England.
Hello.
Hello, Marlene. And they are absolutely incredible, all of
them.
But first of all, whatever made you do it?
Well, we started to make dolls for our children, who wanted to collect costume dolls and found it very expensive.
Mm.
So I persuaded my husband John to make the first doll. And he became very interested in them, and he went on from there, carving more dolls for me to dress.
So he carves them?
Yes.
And paints them?
He paints them, carves them, and then I take over and dress them.
Now, both of you did actually go to art college, so
yes.
That must have been a help.
Oh, a lot of help, because I was a dress design student before I became a painter, and John is a painter too.
Because they really are, I mean, absolutely delicious, and they all have their own character.
They all develop their characters in the carving, yes. They're all different.
So you never know who's going to come up next?
No, not at all, no.
This one must have surprised you.
Yes, rather, yes.
She's the biggest of your collection, isn't she?
So far, yes.
And she's got beautiful wavy hair, which I would have thought was impossible to make out of wood.
Oh, no, it is possible, yes.
And a beautiful dress, and a necklace, of course, but this is what fascinates me. She's done some really lovely sewing. Well, you have, but...
I have, yes.
That, I reckon, must be very hard on the eyes, Marlene.
It's all right in a very small amount, but I shouldn't like to embroider a tablecloth.
Mm.
No.
No, I can... it would take
yes.
you forever as well.
Yes, it would.
And
yes.
the little old lady behind, I like, with glasses.
Yes, grannies have to have glasses.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
I didn't know about that
yes.
rule. And her baskets, which are beautiful, but must be very difficult to find.
Impossible to buy, but they can be made from garden raffia, which is plaited and then stitched into shape. So that you can make any shape baskets that you want.
So you not only have to design the clothes and everything, but also all the accessories?
Yes, you have to be a basket maker as well.
Dear me, there's a beautiful basket actually just over there. You've got a little
yes.
sort of country group.
Yes.
And she looks as though she has bread in it.
Yes, she actually does have bread, which is
But it's
baked.
Plaited.
It's plaited and shaped into buns and cottage loaves, etc.
So everything is as real as possible?
As possible, yes.
Oh, there's a little lady behind with a little sort of smock.
Yes.
And a gentleman who looks like, what, a Dorset farmer or something.
He is. He's a shepherd, yes.
He's a shepherd. He's got a lovely beard and a beautiful smock, which is completely embroidered.
Yes, it's a smocked front, which took a whole day to embroider. And the original is in the Red House Museum in Christchurch, so it's an authentic smock.
Lovely. Mm. Don't you find it difficult to get the right sort of... you know, patterned materials, because if you get a piece of material with a great big rose on it, it's going to look silly on
it. It'll look out of proportion, yes. So that you have to look around the shops for small prints, which fortunately are in fashion at the moment.
Yes, so you keep your eyes open.
Yes, and buy remnants.
And lace, I suppose, must be kept down to the right size as well.
Yes, it's important to find tiny lace, narrow
You've got some
lace.
Tiny dolls, actually, just over
yes,
there, haven't
yes,
you? There are
yes.
five babies covered in lace.
Yes, they're in their christening gowns, waiting to be christened. Yes.
In a great big bed.
Yes, that's right.
And some little ladies in front as well, all beautifully dressed. My favourite, I must say, is the lady with the pale blue dress and the white spots.
And the mob cap, yes.
Yes, little mob cap. She's got a little daisy on her front, too.
Yes.
And then another old lady beside with a lace front.
Yes, it's Grandma again. These are figures for dolls' houses, so that we have the whole family.
Oh, I see. Mm. So who's the lady with the baby next door to Grandma?
Well, she's either nanny or mother.
But babies must be now impossible to make.
Well, they're very, very difficult, small to work with. But they're made from small pieces of doweling or pieces of wood and painted and varnished again.
Lovely. And you've even got... Who's this down here?
He's the butler.
Gentleman.
Big Victorian houses always had butlers and maids. And,
oh, I see.
Yeah, they complete the household.
The maid in a beautiful purple dress.
Yes.
Now, how would you set about making one of these dolls?
Well, these are made from clothes pegs.
I didn't think you could find wooden clothes pegs anymore.
They are still available. Big stores have them, but you have to look for them.
How much?
They're about 15 pence for 10.
Oh, that's not too bad. So you can
no.
make a couple of mistakes.
You can make lots of mistakes, yes.
Right. So, do you sort of set off by just painting those for your feet?
They can be painted, or if a child has an adult who can handle a knife, then the foot can be carved into a shoe.
Yes, so it looks a little dangerous
cut
to
off.
Do.
It is dangerous, but an adult must do it. And then we put a piece of a doweling or a small piece of wood on the back of the head to make a bun.
Oh, yes, of course. Just to make it but the extra. Arms must be very difficult.
No, they're quite simple, in fact. They're made from pipe cleaners. A hole is drilled through the peg, and the pipe cleaner threaded through.
But suppose you haven't got a drill, Marlene.
If you haven't got a drill, and a lot of people haven't, then the pipe cleaner can be wrapped around and secured at the back with a piece of tape or glue.
Oh, that's good. But that doesn't look very pretty. I'm sorry to be rude, but
no,
it doesn't.
No, it doesn't look very pretty. I quite agree. So what I do is I cover the pipe cleaner with a piece of corset lace, which is hollow and can be threaded over.
Supposing you don't happen to have corset lace at home.
They are difficult to find these days, but if I can't find them, then I just use a piece of silk or ribbon.
Because it's only the hand that's going to show,
yes,
of course.
Yes, just bound round, and they're just
these
the hand shows.
These little knickerbockers look very difficult to make as well.
No,
very
again,
thinly.
They're very, very simple. It's just a piece of straight white material, a row of stitching up, across, and down, yes. And then a section cut out to make a small pair of bloomers.
And then just sort of tack
gather
it round.
Gather it around the waist, pull it up, and stitch it round onto the doll.
And then just build up the rest of the costume.
Just gradually build up with sleeves, which are again straight pieces of material, and a bodice, and a straight piece of material for the skirt.
Oh, that's lovely. So, that's obviously a good idea for some people. Marlene, thank you very much indeed for bringing your beautiful family with you. And perhaps, if you're thinking that you don't know what to do over the summer holidays, if you get some of these pegs and have a little bit of imagination and practice, you can start with these and perhaps end with that.